What is up, y'all? What is up, y'all? I am feeling good. I hope y'all can feel the energy that I put through this camera. It is yours truly, Rick the Prince. You already know, but Surface Sound, subscribe. I made a tweet a while ago about Janet Jackson and the Black Diamond album. Now, if you all don't know, Janet was gearing to release her... Was this her 11th? Either her 11th? Her 12th, I think this was her 12th studio album, Black Diamond. She's gearing up to release this, the top of 2020. You know, she was promoting. She started off this year, right? You could tell Janet had a plan because she started off this year promoting. She was going to talk shows. She was actually outside. She had a new little look with the braids and the fur. Like, she was really giving like a new era. And it was because she was going on the Black Diamond World Tour as well as dropping a new studio album. Now, I'm gonna do a rant about how long it's been since Unbreakable in another video, because Janet, I'm young, okay? You have young fans that need music. I was, you know, just doing some thinking about what I want the Black Diamond album to sound like. Janet Jackson has this gift of touching a lot of different bases in her music. She can do pop, she can do rock, she can do disco, she can do R&B, soul, of course, she can do electric, house, dance. She does it all. You know, but with this album, Black Diamond, I feel like, again, she was going to make another political statement. A lot of her projects, especially her most iconic projects, she makes these statements about feminism and black people and just uplifting us. She's always done that in her music. So I expected this album to kind of follow suit in that, and especially now with everything that 2020 has gave us. I thought, you know, what would the Black Diamond album sound like? I don't know if y'all are on the same level as me, but I really want Janet to tap into kind of like an alternative R&B sound, you know what I mean? I think of artists that she's influenced that people don't even mention. Janet has influenced, you know, the whole whisper, the soft vocals on the melodic melodies. Like, Janet did that and she got criticized her entire career for the way she made music. Now it's literally the standard. I definitely would like to hear her collaborate. This is what the video is really about, is artists that I want Janet Jackson to collaborate on this project. Now, the first one is her. Her did a tribute to Janet Jackson at the BMI like honor ceremony. I think it was this was like in 2018. She did a cover of Anytime, Anyplace. And ever since then, you know, I've really just recognized her and her vocal abilities and her falsetto and just everything that she embodies in her music. And I believe that Janet Jackson, her record makes a lot of sense. Another artist I would want to hear on the album is Tinashe. Now, I know. A lot of y'all may not agree with me, but Tinashe is one of my favorite artists of today. And she has a lot of influence from Janet Jackson. She actually tributed Janet Jackson at the 2015 BET Awards. Ciara is another one. I feel like a Ciara-Janet collab was probably talked about like 15 years ago, and Janet probably was like, no. But I don't know. In recent years, Janet has really showed a lot of love to Ciara. Ciara has constantly showed her love and appreciation for what Janet has done for her career and how she's influenced her. So I feel like a record with Ciara is long, long overdue. Teyana Taylor. Now, Teyana Taylor, the way she be repping Janet, like, that makes me love her alone. Just off that alone. Countless times, Teyana Taylor has showed love to Janet, even since the beginning of her music career, paying tribute and homage to Janet, doing the I Get Lonely. Nobody does I Get Lonely better than Teyana Taylor. Let's be clear. And, you know, she showed love. Janet has showed love to Teyana plenty of times. I think she brought her out to the show, went to see her show, you know, just showed love in so many different ways. Everybody I picked on this list is authentic people. Authentic people that make sense to collaborate with Janet Jackson. Bruno Mars. Now, Bruno Mars presented Janet with the Billboard Icon Award in 2018, correct me if I'm wrong, when she received that award and did her performance. And there was rumors even back then that a Bruno Mars record was in the works. And they've been really, really hush. Like, you gotta respect a team that is hush on such a big collaboration like that. We ain't heard a peep. And they said they recorded that thing years ago. So I don't know what's happening with that, but a Bruno Mars, Janet collab. Oh my gosh, I just smell a number one. Daniel Caesar. Now, Daniel Caesar, I almost want Janet to have several songs produced with Jimmy Jam, Terry Lewis, and Daniel Caesar. Just the way Daniel Caesar makes music, like Take Me Away, Love Again, Japanese Denim, correct me if I'm wrong. Like the way he structures those records, I want Janet on those songs. Like his sound with her voice, I need that. K-Tronada. Like, K-Tronada, why hasn't this K-Tronada collab happened yet, Janet? Okay, he did that If remix in 2012, I want to say? Like, and she's acknowledged K-Tronada and, you know, his talents and stuff, and he's cited Janet as one of the musical artists that he likes. So it only makes sense to have K-Tronada on this album, Janet. It's Kendrick Lamar, of course. She worked with J. Cole on No Sleep in the last project. I think it's only right that she worked with Kendrick on this one. Maybe do some Black Lives Matter type record, something for the people, something for the soul, you know what I mean? And let Kendrick spit some knowledge on there. Like, this is just, these are almost no-brainers to me, but you know, I don't know how the music industry works behind the scenes. I don't know how Janet is behind the scenes and how she does her music and stuff. Of course, this album has to be executive produced by Jimmy Jam, Terry Lewis. As usual, I wouldn't mind Missy being involved in it some kind of way again. I would love to hear Lizzo maybe on the project, maybe. Maybe that's a stretch. Janet takes so long to make an album that I want her to collaborate with more people. Like, I know she doesn't collaborate with a lot of people, but I feel like these are artists. The artists that I just named are artists that are talented as hell, respect Janet, respect her craft, respect what she's done for the culture, and it would compliment Janet. I'm not picking anybody just for the hell of it. Everybody that I chose are people that would compliment her on this album and make this album the best it could be. Because we don't know, this could be Janet's last album. Like, I love Janet, but you know, she don't seem like she's in any rush to make no new music. So this might be her last project. I need this project to have, you know, it be cohesive. I don't need a long project. 15 tracks. 15 tracks is, you know, ideal. Maybe a deluxe a little later. I would love like a documentary. I know they was talking about some type of Netflix thing, but this was years ago. I don't know what's going on. Like I said, you never believe anything unless it comes from Janet's lips, like she always says. But I would like, you know, the tour, the album, a little documentary, because I don't have a Janet documentary. Like, there's not one. There's not a Janet documentary. I mean, she used to have like little things, like little DVDs go with her album and stuff, but I mean, Janet, I want you to treat this album as if it were your last album of your career. I want this album to be beautiful. I'm gonna listen to it regardless. At this point, I'm just rambling. Summer Walker, maybe that's a reach. But I feel like a Summer Walker Janet record would be beautiful. Summer playing on that guitar. And Janet just, we gonna get the sweet. Let go on. Y'all ain't gotta be here with me on that one. Like, man, but those were just a little suggestion. I don't want this video to ramble and go on too long. Y'all let me know. Black Diamond, Janet. Don't know when the album is coming. Of course, we have more important things to worry about right now. I'm glad she didn't like start dropping music and release dates and all that stuff, because then things would have got like really complicated. I think things happened at a point where she had time for her and her team to like regroup and figure out what's going to happen. You know, she did release the tour dates, but you know, tours, everybody's tour has been affected. So I would just really want Janet to just, I don't know, just, you know, bring more of the new era of R&B into her next project. It just makes sense to me. You know, she has nothing to lose. Her legacy is already solidified. Let's do one time for the one time. Like, come on, Janet. But anyways, y'all let me know. It is yours truly, Rick the Prince. Y'all make sure y'all follow me on social media. Links are in the description. Check out my playlist. I did a Pride playlist. I did a Black Lives Matter playlist for Spotify. Y'all make sure y'all do that. Surface Town on Spotify. Surface Town on Spotify. I also have my Beneath the Surface podcast where we interview indie artists that are on the come up. We talk to them about their journey and how they make their music and things like that. Yeah, your boy's out here doing stuff. So y'all need to support. I love y'all. I will see y'all next time. We out.